small but mighty.
Isn't she?
Yeah.
And she went for it the entire time. There was no, forgive me, or I made a mistake, or whatever. You're just there the whole time, which is huge. Huge. So great. You guys as a group have a beautiful combination between the technical aspects of music and a commitment to the emotion. So that's great to see. Can we go back to that first chorus that's really quiet? Because I think your dynamics are good, but I want to get them to be breathtaking. I love you to know breathtaking. Go everything. You are indeed voices. So music now is heavily compressed, which means there are basically no dynamics, and we're not used to hearing dynamics, which means I think that most a cappella groups live here when actually our voices are able to do this. And rather than using piano forte or fortissimo, I like to use a 1 through 10 scale, 0 through 10, 0 silence. And you guys, when you got quiet, you were singing at like 3, and I'd love you to sing it. So quietly, people have to lean in. And then when you get loud, I want to get you as loud as you can be without your voices shredding. But we'll get there. Let's start. Do you need a pitch or whatever? Or are you still?
I think we're good.
Okay. So sing that first chorus. Yeah, cool.
1, 2, 3.
So I think this part of the song, you do plenty of this, there's plenty of that in the song. Let's have this just be boom, right? Really? You do you. Everybody else? Here's the thing, I want you. And but quiet does not mean loud. Right? Show this, we did this. I did this part earlier today, here. I don't want it to be like one of these handshakes where it's like, that's not quiet. Quiet can be super, super intense, right? I can say to you, dude, I hate you. But that is not as intense as. And I'm doing that because I want you to see and I want you to feel and realize how powerful quiet can be. Some of the best things we hear in our entire life, a lullaby, right? The words, I love you. They're often spoken so quietly. So let's make this chorus intense. All right, same place.
1, 2, 3. Well, I've got thick skin and that elastic hook. The charm blade, it might be too sharp, mine like a rubber band. Do you pull too hard? I may snap and I will fast.
Okay, so now you guys have the volume level. But it's not as intense. Like the whole thing went down a little bit because before you were singing with this whatever. What is this song about? What are you singing about here? Why do you have an elastic part? What does this even mean? Go.
You bounce back and you realize you didn't hurt you that bad.
Bingo. So what would we be singing about during the part of the song when you get really quiet and introspective? You'd be singing about the hurt. Thank you, Pat Mosley. Look like his cousin. He's like, what the greatest living being?
So much trouble.
Soldier. Yeah. He's a man. Pat Oswalt's like jeans. So go. Yeah, go on YouTube, hold on that. You'll be so happy. Okay. Yeah, he's also the voice of Christ. But anyway, so this part of the song is where you need to go. These are mistakes. This is the hurt. This is where you go down because then you bounce back from it. Where you slingshot this into the second half of the score being super powerful. But first you need to go, right? So let me see that as well as here. Same place, ready? And when you're counting this in, it should be half level. Yeah, let's switch this up. So go.
Bill.
So that's a moment, right?
First part. How do you get out of that hurt? What is the song? What is the emotion you use to move through sadness into the conviction that you have? It's anger, right? If you start getting built up, no, 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 boom, right?
And they felt that already.
I'm not going to cheer you through this time. I'm not going to open my mouth. I want it to come from in here. And I don't care if your voices rattle by the end of this, because ultimately music is not perfection. Music is about emotion.
And people, your hair started standing up, right? When you, like, they were so quiet. Ooh, wow, you're like, oh, hide me from the awesomeness.
Okay, let's take that same moment. And remember, everything lives in contra, everything lives.
Clean up in aisle three.
Everything exists in contrast with itself. So the quieter you get, the louder you can get. The more introverted you are, the more you can go out. Extroversion, the more you started to hurt, the greater the transition to anger is, right? So really own that beginning so then you can transform.
All right, here we go.
Same thing.
Like a thick skin and an elastic heart. Sharp blade, it might be too sharp. I'm like a rubber band.
Awesome. So you guys understand how these dynamics work now, right?
And they you guys are like, oh yeah. And we're not used to hearing dynamics like this. So it's like when you go into you first went into a 3D movie theater and the movie, like, you put on the glasses, you're like, whoa, right? When you really hear dynamics, we're not used to them.
They don't exist in pop music, so it's so compelling. Now let's go to the end of the song, you're across the front of the stage. And my 1 to 10 scale, 10 is yelling, someone you're not even pitch, was just screaming, like, you know, your body, like, there's a plane, we're gonna get hit, you know, whatever. Dial it back to a 9, to an 8.5. I want your voices rattling, though. Powerful. This is your testimony, and it's coming out of a complete rejection of the way you felt before. I'm still here, I'm bouncing back. Let me hear it. You know where to start?
Yeah.
It's from, like,
the last chorus.
Yes,
do
da. Something is emoting more conviction, power, and passion than the sum total of the rest of you. You need to step it up. And I'm telling you this because she's right there in front of you. You're in the same group, you have the same experience and all that kind of stuff. She's just boom, boom, boom. And the rest of you guys are boom, boom, boom. Right? Boom. No, this is music. Bam. But turn around, sing that chorus for them. Stay right there and sing. One, two, three, go!
Yes, right?
You're not used to hearing people sing with that kind of power.
The only thing I would change this time, she's not going to look at you. You guys are now going to look out in people's eyes, to them, sing to them, tell your story. Can we go back to that last, I've got an elastic heart, back down to one? Really quiet and intense, like what have I done, right? You grab all this, bam, bam, and all of a sudden, shoot, right? That will be chills. You do that right, zing, chills, okay? Every single one of you, you're starting to get it. It really helped when she was facing you, but we need her in the front lines, we need her in the trenches out there, pulling people in. So use her energy to pull you into the rest of the song. You ready? We're only going to do this one more time. That's it. Then we're moving on to the next song. This is your one chance. You going to do this?
Yes.
Yeah.
All right. Let's hear it. Chills. Give them chills. Are you ready?
Yes.
Students. The true commitment to putting yourself out there emotionally.
Yes.
Awesome. One more song?
Yeah.
They have the benefit, by the way, of going at the end of the day, so they've heard everything else, so they're like, oh, we better do that thing. So. Thank you for going earlier and making it easier on us, is what I'm saying.
Will you take my hand?
So it's just really good. So that's nice. But I wonder if we can exaggerate the differences between the verses and the chorus so there's a real sense of like, bam, it's arrived. And in particular the part where you're singing, I want to be a kid again. What can we do to make that even more like believable? More, yeah, if you pull it back down and you're like, something like that, and you guys are all like, it gets kind of cute, and you're like, oh, I want to be a kid again, and then, wham! People are like, oh, damn! where's a good place to start? So that part of the song, when you're singing, I want to be a kid again, let's make it a little more kid-like. Let's make the vowels brighten a little bit. There's this doo doo, like it's a little young. And then, wham, we can hit the chorus hard. So it goes through all of the background parts. And that might even mean the percussion, it goes from the richness of a full kid into almost having a high-pass filter on it. So it's or so whatever you do, yeah. And then it goes back. So try something like that. Well, yeah, whatever. Have that lightness and brightness, dark and bam, right? So those odd chords, it can be like, ah, right? So same thing second time. Second chorus.
this I feel I must finally show.
Song, you sang your last note, and then you're like, all of you guys, you can't and should never apologize for your solos. When you're done with your solo, you're done. Accept the applause, right? There's a communication that happens between a performing group and an audience. You do your thing, and they keep quiet for the most part during it, and then afterwards, they let you know how they felt about it. And if you sing a whole song and it's beautiful and then you're like, oh, never mind, it wasn't so good, whatever, you're almost telling them that they're patient and you're not letting them talk back. So it's almost like you're saying, hey, how you doing? How was your day? Right? Let them speak back to you, first of all. And second of all, these nerves, hopefully we'll get rid of these so that you can sing the song and let it just be, right? Because that's about it.
Mr. I'm 15 and my voice sounds like I'm...
This is true for everybody in the backgrounds too. Like, it's not just him. All of these nervous tics, these habits we have, you know what I hate? And I didn't see it very much today at all. I hate this thing. Someone's up here singing and they do this, or they do this thing, or you know what I mean? It's your body language is apologizing for what, oh no. I didn't hit this note right or whatever. No, don't do that. you're taking away, and frankly, you're also interrupting the efficacy of your instrument. You're making it harder for yourself to actually have good technique and all that. But, boom, you're up there, you have the solo, it's yours, go. Hands down, right? End of the song, boom, thank you, I'm done. And then when they're done applauding, then you can step back. And not this thing, okay? All right,
yeah.
Promise?
Yeah.
And this is for you, all of you guys as well. Think about what the song means. Why are you singing the song? What's the point there? And let that guide your body a little bit. Let that reflect your posture. There are times when the song, you're down. I mean, in the previous tune, you're down, you're sad, or whatever, and then you pull your energy back up. This is different. This is almost reverential. The body language of the song isn't this, it's this, right? And maybe we can find a way for you to disappear during the whole building section, and then you can come back out into the group rather than have to be in the front and be like, and that's all. This is true for all the rest of you guys. How your posture reflects the song. It says a lot. You can choreograph your way into making different kinds of statements, but when you stand and you sing a song, all of it, where your shoulders are, where your chin is, all that ends up sending subtle messages. Anyway, you guys are awesome.
Round of applause.